If you're up and about at 6:30 a.m., we've got news for you. King 5 Morning News with Don Madsen.
For more than a decade, Don Madsen was the face of morning news.
Good morning. It's Friday, December 3rd. Here are the top news stories.
King 5 launched the first early morning newscast in all of Western Washington, hitting the airwaves in 1980 with Jeff Renner on weather and a Cessna 150 covering the roads with Sky Twin traffic. At first, Madsen wasn't sure about news before dawn.
And I said, what? Yeah, 6:30 in the morning. He said, okay. And he said, just be a tight news show. You're going to do news, weather, and sports.
61-year-old Des Moines dentist Barney Clark is in critical but improving condition this morning.
And there was no looking back. King 5 dominated. When the first person in the world received an artificial heart, the name of the game was improvised.
We're going to join him now for an update on his condition. Good morning, Aaron. What's happening?
Good morning, Don. We just talked to the hospital. Dr. Clark is described this morning as doing well.
The producer said, just pick up the damn phone and talk to him on it. And I said, well, that looks really silly. He said, well, that's the only way you can do it.
Let's give him the signal to light the charges. Igniter's on.
King 5 was a pioneer, paving the way for local morning programming.
Seattle Today, weekdays at 9 a.m.
Seattle Today joined the morning lineup in 1974.
Here is Gail McDermott with the Olympia Little Theater.
Fun, live, and lively talk show hosted for more than 17 years by Cliff Lenz.
One of the great days of my life, being told that I had passed muster and I was going to come to work for Mrs. B, Mrs. Bullitt.
The show evolved over the years.
Cliff Lenz and Good Company.
Changing its name, but not its 9 a.m. time slot. For a stretch, Seattle Today, the only local show with a live audience, was the most watched locally produced morning show in the entire country, with a 65% share of the audience.
You talk to some of the most outstanding, famous movers and shakers in the world. We had the vice president, Nelson Rockefeller, on the show. We had Ginger Rogers. We had, you know, legends of entertainment, legends of sports, Muhammad Ali.
For 18 years, Seattle Today was a staple for Northwest viewers. On the air longer than Bonanza.
King 5 Morning News, giving you an edge first thing in the morning.
In September of 1990, King 5 would expand again. With more than 60% of people getting their news from television, the morning team grew to three.
Only $425,000.
Dennis Bounds came on board. I moved from the weekend anchor desk along with Rich Marriott, and soon, that half hour of news, it expanded too.
And then there was a snowstorm, and we did 2 hours of news. Went, you know, I think we can do an hour.
Even that didn't last. 1 hour eventually became two, then two and a half with full-time traffic.
From around the Northwest and beyond, this is Seattle Live.
Fast forward to August 2004, and King 5 would grow its lineup yet again.
Easy answer, just sleep in.
Yikes, we're in trouble.
Yeah, we're in real serious trouble.
Doesn't bode well for us at all, does it?
Does not look good. They're going to have to get a wider camera lens for us.
Seattle Live launched 14 years ago, bringing 2 hours of news and entertainment to cable viewers across the Northwest. Today, you know it as King 5 Mornings on Kong.
I'm Jake Wittenberg.
And I'm Amy Jung. Happy Friday to you. Cam's got an eye on the traffic.
I'm seeing some stubborn fog in places right now. We've got a couple of blocking issues.
First of all, I feel so lucky to be working in the city where I grew up. And then to be working at King 5.
King 5, still leading the way. Now in its new state-of-the-art home in SoDo. New digs and the latest in technology.
We got Dexter the drone up here on a Monday morning. You're looking at our live picture.
With people you know, always looking for the best ways to keep you informed on the issues you care about, weather reports where you live, and the traffic information you need. Yes, much has changed since 1948, but not the vision.
Dorothy Bullitt, you know, favorite person of everybody in the world, and it was kind of considered the Camelot of local news.
Or the mission.
King 5 has always been kind of the backbone of television news.
Turn to Western Washington's number one news team for breaking news and continuing coverage of the top stories.
I mean, the people here aspire to be the best that they can, and I think that is the legacy of King. I mean, it isn't just that King is that great, but that it inspires people to be great when they come here.
But I do think of myself as a guardian of the legacy that is King 5 News, and what does it mean to be part of the home team? And it just makes me proud to be a part of it.
Isn't that what it's all about? You want to leave a legacy behind of having made the world a little better place, made your community a little better place, and I think King has done that admirably over the years.